Tired of the everyday grind? Ever dream of a life of romantic adventure? Want to get away from it all? We offer you escape. Escape, designed to free you from the four walls of today for a half hour of high adventure.
You are trapped in a snowbound cabin in northern Canada, with the temperature slowly dropping, while across the table from you, his eyes staring at you, is your only companion, a madman waiting for his chance to kill you.
Listen now as Escape brings you Anthony Ellis's terrifying story, A Study in Wax.
Late October when the Radio Shack burned down. We never did decide whose fault it was. Maybe it was Cabell with his cigarettes, or maybe me. Anyway, I guess the whole thing began when we lost the phone transmitter and receiver. Cabell and I had been sent up to the Northwest Territory by the Canadian Geodetic Survey people. It was a long job. The biggest part of it was the loneliness. I remember what Cabell said as we watched the government supply boat steaming off.
Well, it's gonna be a long winter.
Yeah, hope they don't run into any trouble on the way back. That ice is closing in fast.
Yeah. So long, fellas. See you next spring. It's getting cold.
Feels like snow. Probably get some tonight.
Yeah.
Well, we might as well get the rest of this stuff unpacked, huh?
All right. It's kind of lonely with them gone, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess it's the quiet.
You'd better get used to it.
Oh, I will. It's funny, you know, after spending most of your life in cities, I suppose you'd feel this kind of thing more. There's an awful lot of nothing out here.
You need a drink. Come on.
It wasn't that Cabell was moody or anything like that. I think he wasn't used to being out of touch with people and things that he was accustomed to in the city. I was the opposite. I kind of liked the loneliness. As a matter of fact, now that I think about it, we were a pretty strange couple to hit it off the way we did. And when you got 7 months to spend alone with another man, you've got to be sure of each other. And we thought we were, until after the radio was gone. That day it burned, we stood in the snow watching the embers glowing and the wisps of smoke rising into the cold sky.
Well, it's gone.
Still got the code center, just in case.
Yeah, I know. But I'm gonna miss the programs and the music.
I tell you, we could send a message to the base if you like, ask him to fly out another receiver.
Oh, no. You know old McLeod, he'd boil. Waste of money. He'd probably take it out of our pay. No, we'll do without it.
Well, it's all right with me.
You're a hardy soul. I don't think you'd mind if you had to stay here alone for 7 months, you know?
It'd be dull. I wouldn't have anybody to beat at chess. Well, I think we better use the theodolites tomorrow. Get to work on that western section over in the range, triangulation.
All right. Oh, Jack.
Yeah, what?
If it was my cigarette that burned down the shack, I'm sorry.
Forget it. I may have done it myself. Forget it.
By the end of November, we'd done pretty well as far as work was concerned. But Cabell was getting jittery. We had a week stretch where we couldn't move out of the camp. It was around 30 below outside and blowing 60 miles an hour. Cabell had read most of the things we'd brought along and was sitting at the table trying to beat his solitaire game. I was oiling my gun.
Ah!
Odds are against you every time.
Don't I know it. I wish this weather would ease off.
It will.
Hey, I got an idea.
What?
What do you say we open our Christmas presents tonight?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.